It has to be the end of COP1 when we adopted the Berlin mandate. And for me, it was the end of a cycle of intense travel combined with my first pregnancy and the birth of our daughter, who was born in 1994, but then came to virtually all of the meetings, either in my womb or in person to many of the meetings. So the whole of that period is very much tied up with birth of a new era, personally, and also for the multilateral realm as well, and hopes for that. It has to be, I think, when we had this celebration on a boat trip on the Rhine at the end of what was called COP6 bis, which was in July, very hot period in Bonn, and this very intense political sort of set of negotiations that were very complicated and ended up rescuing the failure at The Hague. So we've had a couple of big failures. And it was fun, and it was very funny, because all the negotiators, the senior negotiators, danced. So the sight of seeing these very stiff, you know, men and women, but a lot of the men who had been fighting each other very hard, dancing on this boat down the Rhine was hilarious. As well as the fact that the boat broke down and had to be sort of fixed by the police, so that was quite a funny moment. I have to say I've been really fortunate. I think I must be the only person who's never lost their luggage en route with all the transition and horror stories. So I don't have a really arduous travel moment, but I do remember the worst travel trip physically was to and from Kyoto, which was, I think I spent 3 full weeks in Kyoto itself. And the most arduous bit of the journey was at the beginning, when it was before the digital age. We had to take 400 briefings from the plane to Kyoto, and thankfully the Japanese travel system was marvelous. So there was a sight of all these interns and me carrying cardboard boxes. That was quite hilarious. Well, it will be cold, but I think some kind of boat trip or a series of boats, a flotilla, would be, I think, a very nice thing. We've got the River Seine, and those bateaux mouches go up and down all the time, so that would be fun. And failing that, I think some kind of giant concert and music, and we've never really had that. We've not had a positive end point where we actually celebrate NGOs, as citizens, as negotiators, and as politicians all together. Too many times people come and go at different points. So yeah, that's what I'm looking forward to.